FL Studio 21 is in the works, but what can we expect from this next major version of FL Studio? What do we know so far? Will it be a huge overhaul or just an incremental improvement? In this video, I'll show you some teasers of what they're currently working on. If this is your first time here and you want to learn all about FL Studio and music production in general, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell as well. If previous updates are any indication, I'd say we can definitely expect bigger changes in version 21 compared to ordinary updates, as they tend to save some of those really big changes for their major releases. For example, the introduction of FL Studio 12 was a huge leap forward because it introduced the new vector graphics. In fact, this was such a huge graphical overhaul that many declined to update because it just felt too unfamiliar. In order to celebrate the 20th anniversary, and due to a fair amount of superstition, they decided to skip version 13 altogether and move straight to version 20. There we got a complete and much-needed overhaul of the plugin delay compensation system, time signatures, multiple playlists, and more. There's a thread on the official FL Studios forums which shows us some of the things they are working on for version 21. As you can see here, we're finally able to draw envelopes directly on audio clips. It's quite tedious to constantly add automation clips every time you want to adjust the levels of a vocal, for example, or just do some quick fade in or fade out. In FL Studio version 21, you'll be able to just draw this directly on the clip itself. This won't replace the automation clips, though. It will just be a supplement. They should definitely help speed up your workflow. Another thing, and I know this is a big one for some of you, it seems like more customization options will finally be coming to version 21. Here we can see a dark theme, so themes or skins of some form will definitely be coming to version 21. I don't think it'll be just themes though. I suspect there will be at least some degree of customization available here, because they've repeatedly promised that they're going to make it possible to substantially customize the graphical user interface in the future. This has been a big deal for many since the introduction of FL Studio 12, when it was no longer possible to add different skins like in older versions. There used to be tons of different skins to choose from, and it seems like some degree of customization will finally be possible again. Personally, I'm still hoping we'll get a real folder track architecture in the playlist, like many other DAWs. They've done some improvements to the grouping system, and that's a step in the right direction. But that's not still anywhere nearly as useful as a real folder track architecture. I'd also like to see improvements to time markers and things of that nature. And why can't I just drag and select a section here, name it intro, and give it a color? That would make it easier to arrange and organize a track. This is possible in many other DAWs, and this is starting to feel a bit outdated in comparison. Will this be added to FL Studio version 21? Who knows? That's just some of the things I'd like to see added. These were just some of the features you can expect to see in the final version. There's a lot more coming, and the best thing is that all these features are free since FL Studio, unlike other DAWs, comes with free lifetime updates. I'm curious though, what would you like to see added in FL Studio 21? Is there anything in particular you feel is missing? Or perhaps something that's just not working well for you right now? Leave a comment below and let me know. Let's have a little discussion and see what the top feature requests and annoyances are. I'd like to thank our Patreons for their ongoing support. Also, make sure to check out the links below if you need feedback on your music, mastering, and so on. Thanks for watching!